everybody, Steph here and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking you through my Kindle. This is a Kindle Paperwhite, I think, and I've had it possibly a couple of years now. I really enjoy having a Kindle. I like having access to lots of books. What I don't particularly like necessarily is reading on it, and I've probably got about 70 books in total on here. I am signed up to a couple of websites. BookBub is one and Kind of Book is the other, and every day you get an email about books that are on offer, free books, and I used to, but I don't really anymore, get books from NetGalley, which is generally sort of proof copies before they're published. But what I thought was, because I've not done any BookTube videos for a while and somebody has asked me if I'm going to do them, is because I've been reading on this, I thought I would quickly kind of take you through what I've read on the Kindle. Now, some were read quite a long time ago, and being honest, I have already filmed this video. I then took the memory card out, ready to take it downstairs and put it in my laptop. But because I bought a new camera, I then decided to format the memory card ready to put in my new camera for weekend vlogging, forgetting that I'd not actually downloaded the stuff off to the laptop. But we're going to go for it again. You're going to have to excuse some of the background noises. My neighbour is moving out to her boyfriend, who lives at the end of the row, and his daughter's moving in, and they're doing a lot of DIY, and there's a lot of sewing and a lot of drilling going on. That is downstairs and I am upstairs, so hopefully it's not going to be too bad. But I'm going to make two of these videos, so you're going to see them. They'll probably be up a week apart. I have been putting videos up on Fridays and Sundays, and I think if I can get enough BookTube videos sort of under my belt over the next couple of weeks, I'll put them up as bonus videos on Wednesdays. Sunday is the vlog. Friday, I don't know what Fridays are. I've got a few like random things that I've bought videos. There'll be more sit down talky videos. So if I've not got anything filmed, I'll put a BookTube video up on Friday, otherwise you'll get bonus Wednesday videos. I think I've not brought my diary up, so we're not sure, but let's get into it. So this video I'm going to go through four of the older books that I've read. Now hopefully, with already filming this, it will have jogged my memory, because I did have to look on Goodreads. So the first book is Wildflower Bay by Rachael Lucas. Now I've got it as a three-part novella on my Kindle, but you can get it as one single book, which I would probably recommend doing rather than having the three novellas. They're very kind of short reads. It's based on my reading speed, it says this book would last 10 minutes. And I love Rachael Lucas' books. I'm not just saying that because she's my Facebook friend. I don't think she knows who I am, but we are Facebook friends via the blogging community. But this, I bought myself, I think they were 99p for each edition. And this is set in Scotland, so you've got, I think she's called Isla, the main character, and she has, not high powered, she's a hairstylist in a fancy Edinburgh salon, and something goes wrong and she then has family problems, and her dad encourages her to move to an island, I think it is in the north of Scotland, to help her auntie run her auntie's hairdressing salon. Now this salon is very community based and it's very old fashioned. There's a hairdresser named called Doris and Joan. Now, if anything like me, thought that's exactly how I pictured this hairdressers in Scotland. Very kind of old lady, blue rinse. I think the original signage from the 50s, that kind of thing. And she kind of modernising it, and it's a story of how she like wins over the community and, you know, helps to train up the salon girl and, you know, finds out about from being an outsider to being a member of the community. And all the things like that. It's quite predictable, but it's a fun read. It's perfect for on your sun lounger, and I would definitely recommend it. I you know, I really enjoyed it. I've read a couple of other of Rachel books, and I think they have the same characters in, and it's like set in the same place, and it's a really lovely read. The next one I want to talk about is Girl on the Train by Paula Hawkins, and this in theory should be right up my street. I love, one of my favourite ever books is Gone Girl, and I've read it about 6 times, and I love that kind of thriller, whodunit, psychological, I don't know what that noise was. I'm assuming that was outside. Psychological mashup of did they, didn't they, who did what. And this starts to go down that same sort of vein, but it's just something missing for me. However, what I would say is I've watched the film as well, and the film and the book are basically two different things with the same name and similar ending. The film is set in America, and it's just not right. Obviously, Girl on the Train, it's a girl, a woman rather, on a train, and if you're a commuter like I am, I get the Metrolink every day, you tend to see the same people every day, you go past the same, you know, it's the same route because it's a track, and you get to know people, and sometimes you're like, oh, I've not seen them for a few days, I wonder if they've changed shifts and things like that. And she sees things on her route, or she thinks she sees things, or she sees things and people don't believe her. It just kind of gets really, really twisted. But in the book, it's in England, in London, I think, and the gardens are like the 100-foot, I don't really know measurements, but you know, like really long gardens, how you would imagine if you go on a train, because in England gardens tend to be very long if you live near a railway to counteract the noise. In the movie, it's just basically a yard like that wide and train track at the bottom, and it doesn't fit the story. So where I'm going with this is, since seeing the film, I appreciate the book far more, and I think the book is excellent compared to the film. Although I did enjoy a lot of elements of the film, I definitely had to think of them as two very separate stories. So each have their own merits, but I would definitely say if you like things like Gone Girl, I would definitely try and read the book. I know it's quite old now. And okay, so then we have The Handmaid's Tale by Margaret Atwood. This, I'm guessing, quite a lot of people read. I know a lot of people that said they have to read it at school. My school, we didn't read anything like this. And to be honest, I can't really remember any of the books I read at school. I read a book about the Chilean hunter. And read The Merchant of Venice, but I don't remember any of the books that I read for GCSEs. But this is kind of like a dystopian, almost, you actually could almost see, like with Donald Trump, you could almost like imagine something like this happening, whereas things of the world has shifted. Women have like no rights in the world except to produce children for the, you know, they've lost their identities, and they're not allowed to be called by their own name, they're called. So the main character is Offred, but it's Of, and then her master, owner, guardian, keeper is Frederick, who's known as Fred. So it's of Fred, and then you'll have of Glenn, of Pete, Peter. You think you like that. So it's quite clever how it's been done, because when you first start reading it, of Fred could be a name. And then you get off Glenn, and it kind of sort of becomes more clear. So I think it's really clever how it's been done. I've read this a number of times, and every time I read it, I get something else from it. The TV series that's been done as well is, for my mind, is excellent, and it's a very difficult watch, but I've enjoyed it. I've still not watched the full first series yet. I need to try and find out where I can catch the last few. And the last book I want to talk about for this video is, I can't remember. Let's talk about this one. This is The Crossing Places by Elly Griffith. And this is a series, I believe there's 10 in this series. And this is the Dr. Ruth Galloway Mysteries. I really enjoyed this. This is the first one. But what I would say is, they're quite expensive to buy through Amazon. They're all at least a fiver, which might not be that much, but because of how many books I buy, I definitely find it quite expensive. This was published in 2009, and again, this is like a murder mystery. A body is found on an archaeologically significant site, and they don't know whether it's modern or ancient burial. And Ruth Galloway comes in, and as you might have guessed, solves the mystery. But it's a really nice story. I really enjoyed it, and I found it quite quite engaging. The one thing I would say is the main character is very body negative. And I think it's just about size 14, 16, and there's a lot of, oh, I'm so fat. And you're like, you don't need that. It doesn't matter how big or little you are to solve a murder. You can do it, Ruth. That was the only thing I found quite, not upsetting, but unnecessary. That is probably the best way of describing it. So I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to do another video in a minute talking about another 5 books that I've read on this Kindle, and I hope you like that little book wrap up. I'm sure you've heard me talk about some of those books before, because I'm sure they've been in other wrap up videos, but I thought it's a nice way, and without me rooting through all my books, I've dug out a couple of books to actually do a paperback video shortly. And what I think I might need to do is a to be read pile, because not to be read, like a mid reading pile, because I've got about 6 books that I've started. Some are on here that I just can't seem to finish, or I just don't reach for. So I'm going to leave it there for this video, and I will say thank you very much for watching. I would really appreciate if you'd leave me a comment. Let me know if you've read any of these books. Let me know if you're planning on reading them, or if I've put you off, or if I've encouraged you. If you could subscribe, we're on 275, it's gone up slightly. I just really appreciate every single one of you. It's free to subscribe, all you need is a YouTube account, it doesn't cost you anything, and in theory you should get notified when I post videos. But yeah, if you're new, hello. If you've been here a while, hello. It should be an equal hello. I'm gonna go because this is getting really stupid, and thank you very much, and see you next time.